Welcome back. Now, the presence of President Uhuru Kenyatta during the launch of Machakos City last week was a sigh of great relief for Governor Dr. Alfred Mutua. His critics, of course, had their fingers crossed, hoping the president didn't turn up. In fact, if it was in their power to stop the launch altogether, they could have gladly done it. Well, in politics, opponents will always be there. The challenge is normally how you deal with them. For Wavinya Ndeti, former Kadiani member of parliament, she battled in the ballot ring, but the governor took the highest points. Come to the court of law ring, the governor took the crown. So what is her stand on what the governor is doing currently? Welcome to the Power Breakfast.
Thank you.
Thank you so much indeed. Perhaps before we get to the meat of the matter, after politics, so what are you currently doing?
I'm the IYF Chief Advisor Kenya, Youth Chief Advisor Kenya, and by profession I'm a computer scientist. Mm-hmm. So I'm back in my computer business.
Mm-hmm. You know, it's quite interesting that a lot of people after politics they sort of disappear from the radar, but you are appearing again, strong.
But let me tell you, if it's very important to educate your children. Politics. Sometimes it's a contract for 5 years. Yeah? People might decide to renew or not renew, and it might also be taken from you. And if you don't have anything to fall back onto, then you fall into depression. So you have to pick yourself and move on. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Now, when you want to talk about the Machakos County, now as we speak, yes. In what capacity will you do that?
What do you mean?
You are not a politician, you are not, you are in youth advice.
I'm a leader.
Yes.
I'm a leader in Ukambani and Machakos County. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Looking at Dr. Alfred Mutua, of course, he's a person who has been touted as the man to look at in terms of example, setting the pace. Just last week, launched the Machakos City project. From your own assessments, just about 8 months now, how would you rate his performance from your perspective?
First, the people who would really rate Mutua very well are the people from the ground. Yeah. What is happening on the ground? And it is also fair for the media sometimes to try and get to the ground and see what is happening on the ground. Has he delivered what he told people he would deliver in 6 months, in 100 days? You know, that needs to be gauged also. And I'm not here, really, to talk about him. I'm here to talk about the issues of Machakos County and Kenya as a whole. Yeah, but it's for the people to gauge him. And if you go on the ground, the people would give you the right information. And from my point of view, mm-hmm. as a leader from Machakos County, and also a person who is born and brought up in Machakos County, the issues that are priorities have not yet been tackled. If we, the biggest issue in Machakos County is water. Water is everything. We have spent a lot of money on trips, on media, advertising, on pump, but the bottom line, that person from down there does not have water yet. We have land in Machakos. Most of us have land. But the biggest problem we have in Machakos County is water. If we only got water in Machakos County, we would be very, very far. How many dams have been created this year? How many people are opening water on their taps? With even 20 million, you can be able to do a dam that can supply over 5,000, 10,000 people. We have to put our money where our mouth is.
Are you trying to
get, let me finish. Yeah. We have to get our priorities right. Our priority is water in Machakos County. The other priority is health. Health, having dispensaries and health centers close to the people. We can have ambulances, but ambulances will carry you and take you very far. The roads are also not good. the having services closer to the people is a better way of approaching things. We talk about education. In Machakos County, we have more primary schools than secondary schools. For example, this year, we have students who are leaving standard 8, and some of them might never see the door of a secondary school. Why? Because we don't have enough schools. And even that, the primary schools are also not enough. If you go to some of them, the children are crowded. Most of our children get to standard 8, and that's it. If you go to many homes, you find, sincerely speaking, most of the house girls, house boys, watchmen are cambers. Why? Because their level of education is very low. We have to get our priorities right in Machakos County. We have to have more schools, more primaries and secondaries, colleges and universities. That is a priority. You can come up with a city. If your people are not well educated, they become third class to that city. The city idea is a very good one. And I remember even in my manifesto, if you get into my manifesto, that was one of the ideas we would try to come up with our own city somewhere in Machakos. And I support him on that, but it depends on how he's doing it. You have to prioritize in a home, even here in cities and everywhere, you have to prioritize. So I've said education. The other thing is electricity and roads. There are so many. We keep on talking about poor people. Oh, our children are poor. I cry for that poor young child in Machakos County. How many children are at home today because of lack of bursary? How much money are we collecting in Machakos County? Let us get our priorities right. We should provide bursaries and schools for our children to keep our children in school. And that is one of the things I did very well in Kadiani constituency on education.
Right. Just looking at what you've been saying, your priorities, water, health, education, electricity and roads. Mm-hmm. So you're simply saying the governor has his priorities absolutely misplaced.
I have no fear. I have no fear saying that. The governor needs to be closer to the people. He needs to understand that person down there and what their needs are. You see, if in Machakos County, I cannot come and talk. Who knows about Formula One in Machakos County? Yeah? Before I know about you bringing Formula One, let me have food on my table, good education. You cannot have people who are hungry, uneducated, and sick.
I don't think you are being fair to the governor. Yesterday we interviewed them at length at church, and he addressed all those issues I was talking about. In fact, he said that the members of parliament, almost 100% of county assemblies, are with him. He addressed the issue of poverty in the villages. He addressed the issue of education. He addressed the issue of health centers, dispensaries. All those things he addressed.
You can talk about this. I'm talking about you're here, you're sitting as this red seat.
Yes.
At this red seat in the Citizen Stadium. You here, you can talk about this. But sincerely speaking, we need to be fair to the people of Machakos County. You need to go down there.
Is it true?
And find
Let
out,
me give you an example.
And find out what's happening.
Has he given chicks?
To given people? What?
Introduced poultry farming to young people.
The poultry farming I know we were doing for the youth was through the Ministry of Youth, and we even bought incubators when I was the assistant minister. I know we had that project in the Ministry of Youth.
Are you saying, are you denying him that?
You know, let me ask you, Mutegi, were we here to speak about Mutua or to talk? No, I'm just asking you kindly. We need to talk about the issues, with the issues of Machakos County, the issues that affect the people of Machakos County. About the poultry project, I have told you what we rolled out when I was the assistant minister for youth in the Ministry of Youth. And I'm not here to take his glory. Don't get me wrong. No, I am not. Whatever he does for the people of Machakos, and is good, it is to my interest also, right, because those are our people.
You have said he hasn't gone to the ground. He does not go there. He's a man of publicity.
Now, you're putting words in my mouth.
That's what you said.
You're putting words in my mouth. I've said you should also go down there yourself and see what is happening.
Right. You know, just to put the record straight, of course, you're saying we're talking about issues concerning Machakos County. At the same time, we need to also understand that we cannot talk about Machakos County
without talking
about the governor. Just like talking about Kenya without talking about President Kenyatta doesn't really augur well. But looking at what you've been talking about, especially the priorities that you want to focus on, we have Dickson Mutiso, who says, you have been there for 5 years. Why didn't you bring water to Machakos and more secondary schools?
If I tell you, if you go to Kadiani constituency, I can give you the figures. Athriva, when I was in Athriva, there were 3 secondary schools. By the time I left there, we had 13 secondary school. My record speaks for itself.
But you see,
but Mutu has been there for only a few months.
Absolutely, and the fact that he was given this,
you see, I don't want you to take this, and I don't want it to be taken personal, as if I'm coming, you know, because I can see Mutegi being, you know, I don't want it to be taken as if, look, let us talk about, I'm not coming here to accuse him, okay? I'm not coming here to accuse, I'm coming to talk about the issues. First of all, one of the issues that brought me here is about the land that he's talking about. The land that is going to start the Machakos city. Do you know the history of that land? His idea, don't get me wrong, his idea is very good. Starting a city in Machakos is very good. But the due process must be followed. This land was given by the colonial government. It was taken by the colonial government in the 1920s. The land was set aside by the colonial government in 1905 for livestock livestock improvement center, and the land was 3,594 acres, which was LR number 1491. Okay? Later, the land was subdivided into three lots, which we had that was in the 1920s now. The colonial government subdivided the land into three parcels. The first parcel was 10 acres, which was LR number 1491/1. Yeah? That 10 acres was reserved for veterinary, as for a veterinary clinic. Okay? The second one, LR number 1491/2 and LR number 1491/R was reserved for veterinary farming. Now, in the 1990s, the Machakos Municipal Council requested the central government to give them the land LR number 1491, /R, to expand the Machakos town, and the government granted the Machakos people, they allocated the Machakos Municipal Council the land. When they allocated the land, it was they looked at it, they surveyed and subdivided it and allocated it to institutions. That was allocated to institutions. It was allocated to institutions and other private business people. People have already acquired title deeds on that land. Others, and by the way, this was when they were allocated the land, it was gazetted on legal notice, gazette number 2957 of 16th of July 1995. The legal gazetteman is there. for the LR number 1491/R. The land, as I told you, was allocated to institutions. Other people were given title deeds. There are people with title deeds on that piece of land. Others have paid for their letters of allotment. Okay? Others did not get to pay for their letters of allotment because there was a case that was put in court. Why was the case put in court? It was put in court by the Kima Kimwe people, saying that that was the ancestral land, that that is where they used to farm, and they don't see why people should be given their land. Yeah, the case is in court. And the case number was in the High Court 2765 in 1998. Now it was transferred to Machakos. When it was transferred to Machakos, it is now case number 255/2009 in Machakos High Court. This land that the LR number 1491/1 already has people. This is land with dispute. I'm telling Mutua, if we are going to start a city in Machakos, and I will support him to start a city in Machakos, let us look for free land that we are not going to give free, because there is no free land. Land, if you take the acres he's talking about, 2,200 acres. 2,200 acres, that is prime land. Multiply by 10 million per acre. If you multiply by 10 million per acre, that is 22 billion Kenya shillings. The 22 billion Kenya shillings divide by the eight constituencies in Machakos County. That is 2.75 billion per constituency. Somebody who is coming to invest 1 billion, I don't see why they cannot pay 100 million per acre. If we get these people buying the land, that is 22 billion. Mutua is going to hit two birds with one stone. How? This money he will take and reinvest in Machakos County. That will give us a very big leap as a county. Even we'll be ahead of most of the counties in Kenya. Leave now when people are saying we are number one when we are not. If we do that, we are going to be number one. We're going to be number one in Kenya. 2.7 billion is a lot of money per constituency. And those are the things we need to look at. Hitting two birds with one stone. And apart from that, it will be three birds with one stone. Why? These investors will come and invest. They'll continue paying rates, license, taxes to the county. So the county even becomes rich. If there is land, EPZ is in Machakos County. It's in Athi River, EPZ. We still have a very big piece of land in EPZ that is unutilized. Anybody who wants a tax haven or to manufacture their goods, EPZ, there's still a lot of land. And I would like maybe one time you take a walk there and see what is happening.
Right.
The ideas are good, but things have got to be done.
Yeah,
in the right way.
Absolutely.
I'm not here to put down. And anybody who has ideas, and they are good ideas, they should be supported. But how are these ideas being implemented? Are these our priorities?
Right. I mean, earlier on, in relation to the Machakos City project, you
yes.
stated thrice, actually, mm-hmm. it's a good project, it's a good project, it's a good project.
Yes.
But you're concerned about how it is being handled. Now, the presence of President Uhuru Kenyatta at the launch gave what Dr. Alfred Mutua is doing a great deal of credibility to the to the extent that nobody would even think there is a problem in the
but
first place.
But let me tell you, there is a problem, and this is a problem. And that is why I'm requesting my president, Uhuru, to really send people to really look at the matters of this land. And the president had to come. You see, it was all in the media. Let me tell
well,
you.
Had
Let
to
me
come.
Tell you. Mm-hmm. It was all in the media. It was advertised in the media. And if President Uhuru never came to Machakos, it would have looked bad on him. People would have thought, now, he's not interested in Machakos County. He's trying to brush. Let me tell you.
He came to endorse which you
And that was an endorsement.
It's an endorsement.
Look, the president, he came there as the president of Kenya.
He came there to endorse.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he came here there to endorse. But we are telling him, Your Excellency, Mr. President, look into detail. Or not, we are telling you, we are the people of Machakos County. We come from there, we know, and we understand. And that is not the only land, Mutegi, that is not the only land that we have. If it is land in Machakos, let me tell you, people own there even 1,000 acres. There are people in Machakos owning 1,000 acres, 2,000 acres, 500 acres. There's even more land in Machakos. But our land in Machakos County is not for free. That's the bottom line.
Unfortunately, Moshmiwa, you sound as if it's sound grips, in the sense that all those other MPs
were
sour grips. You lost to him. You lost to Mutua.
Mutegi, can I tell you something?
I never
lost Mutegi. I never lost, and you won. We are on the national TV. I want everyone to get onto the website of the High Court and look at the first judgment. The first judgment that Majanja, the first judgment that Majanja put in court. The first judgment that we should not go for a recount. The valid votes and the casted votes do not tally. He cannot tell me where 13,000 votes are. You see, it is in black and white. Mutegi, it is in black. You brought that up. You understand? You brought that up. But the bottom, it is there in black and white.
Well, you are not the governor of Machakos.
And I am not the governor of Machakos now.
He is the governor.
I am not. I never lost. That is your own opinion.
Well,
I know.
The governor.
No, but let me tell you something. In my heart, I know what happened. Even a polling station.
You don't become a governor in the heart.
You see, we are not coming here to fight with you about Mutua or anything.
Okay.
Mutegi, I don't want you to take this as if it's a personal fight or you're fighting for him. I don't want you to come and take it as if it's personal, as if you're here fight for him. Tell me, in a polling station, pick Chasioni. I got 100 votes. It is not irrelevant.
Let's get back to the issues. Let's get back to the issues, because
that all the elected MPs, except the senator and you who lost, all the other people there in Machakos are not opposed. They have not come here.
Mutegi,
people are supporting.
I told you. I told you. Mutegi, I'm telling you, don't cheat. Let us.